And now, from Studio B at Scotch Plains Fanwood High School, Ada Roshansky and Brittany Larkin.
Hello, and welcome to this update edition of 34 News. I'm Ada Roshansky.
And I'm Brittany Larkin. It's almost time for the new year. Not only will you go from writing 2005 to 2006 on your papers, but you should also be working on your New Year's resolutions. The tradition of New Year's resolutions dates back to the early Babylonians. Popular modern traditions consist of losing weight and getting good grades. Let's go on location to hear some of Spiffy High's students' resolutions.
2006 resolutions for this New Year's. I'm here with Lindsay Fitzgerald, a senior. So what's your resolution?
My resolution is to get into college.
What college do you want to get into?
Roger Williams.
Good luck.
Thanks.
I'm here with senior Travis Morgan. So what's your resolution?
My resolution is to get all A's in calculus.
Do you think that's going to be achieved?
I don't know. Sharky is quite a tough one.
Good luck.
Thank you.
I'm here with Junior John. So what's your New Year's resolution?
To gain weight for football.
Okay, well, good luck.
Thank you.
I'm here with Junior Allie. So what's your New Year's resolution?
To stop being pushy and interrupting people for attention.
Well, I hope that works out. I'm here with freshman Marissa. So what's your New Year's resolution?
My New Year's resolution is to get good grades.
I hope you get them. Thank you. And now I'm here with Erica Goldberg, a little freshman. So what's your New Year's resolution?
This New Year's, I'm going to hope for getting a job so I can get some money.
I hope you get a job. And now I'm here with Mr. Opperman. So what's your New Year's resolution?
It's the same as it's been for the last 8 years. Lose some of this belly. I got to lose some weight. You guys have any good plans for me?
If I think of some, I'll let you know.
Okay.
This has been Lonnie Kay, now back to the studio.
Want to send your friends and peers plenty of holiday cheers? Here's your chance. SMAC, Student Movement Against Cancer, will be selling candygrams. A candygram is a candy cane with an attached message to it. You can purchase a slip from any SMAC member for $1. Write out a message, fill out a to and from with holiday greeting, and your candygram will be delivered to homerooms throughout the week of December 19th.
Hi, this is Ted Rosenblatt reporting on location for 34 News here with three SMAC members.
Angela Smith.
Rachel Levy.
And Brian Hessemer.
So, Angela, what's been going on lately?
SMAC is currently selling candygrams for the holiday season.
And, Rachel, how much do they cost?
They're $1, and the money goes to cancer research.
Well, that's great. And, Brian, how many are you planning to buy?
I'm planning to buy maybe about 6 or 7.
And by 6 or 7, you mean 6 or 700, right?
Of course.
All right. Well, that sounds great. This has been Ted Rosenblatt reporting for 34 News on location. Now back to the studio.
The English department will be hosting a book beat for all grades on December 21st. The novel that is being discussed is titled Old School by Tobias Wolff. Also, there will be a graphic novel sale on December 19th, 20th, and 21st, so be sure to stop by and check it out.
With the holidays right around the corner, crazed shopping malls and packed department stores, have you fulfilled your holiday shopping? Even so, have you begun your wish list? With 2005's top gadgets being the new iPod, cell phones, and digital cameras, jewelry is still in the top 5 since 1954. Let's see what's on Spiffy High's wish list.
Hi, I'm Gabrielle Berman on location, and I'm here to ask a few students from the high school about their wish list. So, Arlie, what do you want for Christmas?
Actually, what I really want for Christmas is probably a tattoo.
Oh, that's really cool. What kind of tattoo?
I'm not too sure yet. I haven't really figured out because I want to get something that I really, really like. So, I've yet to find out.
Do you know what part of your body you want to get it on?
Yes, I do. Either my hip or my lower back.
That sounds really cool. And Toby, what do you want for Hanukkah?
Well, probably just loads and loads of cash, because no one ever knows what I want. Me neither. So I'll come to that bridge when I need to, you know?
Sounds cool. Hi, I'm here with Steve, Jeff, and Joe. So Steve, what do you want for Christmas?
I'd like one of those iPod hookups for my car.
That sounds sweet. And Jeff, what would you like?
I want a new huffy red bicycle.
That sounds nice. And Joe, what would you like?
I want a baby.
What do you want, baby?
I want love.
Now back to the studio.
And now let's go to Arts and Entertainment with Morgan Finkel.
Thanks, Ada. Many praises are being given to the newly released Brokeback Mountain and King Kong. Heath Ledger and Jake Gyllenhaal
took a huge chance with the controversial film about the forbidden, unexpected love between two cowboys in Wyoming. It was just named the top film of the year by the New York Film Critics Circle. Critics are now raving about King Kong, the Universal picture that opened just this Wednesday. The movie, directed by the Lord of the Rings director, is about a group of American adventurers who travel to a secluded island in search of a fabled ape. The star of the film, Naomi Watts, plays Anne Darrow, the woman who the ape falls in love with. The movie is expected to break box office records. The most popular gifts this holiday season are the technological ones. Digital cameras will be extremely popular as lower prices make it possible to get a good quality camera for a reasonable price. Also on the hot list are iPods. They've become so popular that people everywhere are rushing out to get the latest iPod accessories, including iTrips, carry cases, speakers, adapters, and even an iPod digital doggy player. With sizes decreasing, features being added, and prices ranging from very high to very low, people are looking to upgrade to the newest iPods like the iPod Nano, as well as iPods with video and pictures. Now let's take a closer look at some of these gifts.
Strenuous work.
This weekend's top five movies were Chronicles of Narnia, The Lion, the Witch, and the Wardrobe, Syriana, Harry Potter and the Goblet of Fire, Walk the Line, and Yours, Mine, and Ours. Now let's go to Critics Corner with Jess and Matt.
Hello, and welcome to this week's Critics Corner. This week we reviewed Syriana, the new political thriller with George Clooney and Matt Damon. This movie, it's got a lot of acclaim. People thought it was going to win some Oscars. It's one of your typical movies that's supposed to make you think about stuff. But I don't really think very many people got the point of the movie. There's a little too much going on. I mean, it was decent, but just a lot going on. Too much to think about. So, I don't know. I would probably give this movie a C+. Now over to Jesse.
Yeah, I'm not even going to bother reviewing this because regardless of what I say, like Larry said, you're not going to understand what the movie's about, so you'll probably just see Just Friends instead. So enjoy yourself. Back to the studio.
Now let's see what's up this weekend with D-Squared.
Hi, this is Dana Henkin.
This is Danielle Crawford.
D-Squared.
With your weekend preview. This weekend movies, we have King Kong, Harry Potter and the Goblet of Fire, and we also have, if you want to stay home, The Cinderella Man on DVD.
For sports this weekend, there's a boys' basketball game tonight at 4 at the high school, and a girls' basketball game at 4 at Shabazz. This has been D-Squared.
With your weekend preview.
Now back to the studio.
Now let's go to sports with Samantha.
Thanks, Brittany. The Raiders wrestling team is hopeful to have another winning season. Junior captain Pat Mineo and senior captain Nick Giannacci will be participating in the Beast of the East tournament, along with junior Sal Gano. The match will be taking place on December 17th and 18th at the University of Delaware. Kearney will be the team's first competitors on December 19th, so please be sure to show your support. Now let's go on location to find out more.
This is John Mineo on location here with three varsity wrestlers, Sal Gano, Joe Bocci, and Dave DiNicolo. So Sal, who are the key wrestlers this year?
Pat Mineo, Nick Giannacci, Mikey Farrar, Joe Bocci, David DiNicolo, myself, Ricky Olson.
Sounds good. And Joe, who are the captains on this year's team?
This year we have two captains, senior Nick Giannacci and junior Pat Mineo.
And Dave, when's your first match?
Our first match will be this Monday against Kearney.
And good luck to the wrestling team. Now back to the studio.
The Raiders bowling team has been doing well, coming out with a huge win over Westfield last Friday. The team has a 2-1 record, and captains Ron Petty and Matt Hazel hope to keep up the good work. They will be bowling blind, meaning bowling by themselves, next Tuesday at 3:15. Now let's go on location to find out more.
Hello, I'm Mike Bello on location for 34 News. I'm here with senior bowling sensation Troy Morgan. So how's the bowling season going so far?
It's going pretty great so far. You know, we have a record of 2-2. You know, we're really coming to bowl. I mean, everybody comes there. They bowl good games. We got Ron Petty holding his weight as varsity anchor. I, myself, am doing quite a great job on rotating between JV and varsity, but I think it's going to be a good season.
All right, and so I heard you had a big win against Westfield. Want to tell me a little bit something about that?
Oh, yeah. Actually, Westfield has like one of the best teams, and actually we just came there ready to play, and we actually ended up beating them by a good amount of pins. I forget the exact amount, but it was a good amount of pins.
That's great. So good luck with the rest of the season. This has been Michael Bella on location. Now back to the studio.
Thanks, Mike.
Now let's go back to Brittany and Ada.
Now let's go to Car of the Week with John and Pat.
Thank you.
let's see what's storming up with Tornado Ted.
Hi, this is Tornado Ted, reporting for 34 News here with your weekend weather report. On Friday, we have a high of 37 degrees and a low of 15. Saturday, we have a high of 29 degrees and a low of 14 degrees with mostly sunny skies. And on Sunday, we have a high of 25 degrees and a low of 15 with maybe some sleet. This has been Tornado Ted reporting. Now back to the studio.
That wraps it up for this 4-5 edition of 34 News. I'm Brittany Larkin.
And I'm Ada Roshansky. And we'll see you after the winter recess. But make sure to tune in to 6-7's final edition of 34 News in the year 2005.